I'm here with David Chong from the McAllen Central Valley Spanish Church, and you are involved with a team that has been going into several prisons for the last few years and sharing the gospel and seeing lots of people baptized. Say something about that.
So we have a prison ministry going on. It's been going on for about 7 years now. God has blessed us, and we were just at one unit at Segovia, and about, I would say, a year or two ago, God opened the door, and there was a chaplain that wasn't very fond of us there, and for some reason, he did something he wasn't supposed to, and he was let go. And the chaplain we have been working really good with in Segovia told us, I need you guys in Lopez. We need to get your ministry in there, and we've been over there since. We've had about 3 revival weeks already in both units. This last revival week, we've been getting a lot of resistance from other volunteers that go there, passing out literature and papers, talking bad about our denomination, talking bad about LNG White, about our books and our different organizations. We've got resistance from the guards as well at times. Things didn't flow as like they normally do, but for the glory of God, we were able to baptize about 45 people in Segovia and about 42 plus others pending that have already been released or that couldn't make it that day.
Almost 90 people in spite of the resistance.
Correct.
How many of you have baptized over the last 7 years or so?
I estimate, you know, close to 200. We initially, the first about 5 years, we weren't able to do revival weeks or anything like that. We just go in every Saturday. We've been going at the same time that our brothers and sisters worship and go to church from about 10 to 12. That's about the same time we go over there. And we have volunteers. We have a group of about 30 or so volunteers that every Saturday take some time off. Instead of going and fellowshipping with you know, their local church, they decide to go and fellowship with our church that is there in prison, in the two prison complexes. So we're averaging anywhere from 30 to 60 people in attendance every Saturday. We have people there that are, we're teaching them, you know, different music, different hymns. We're taking and we're studying the doctrine with them. It is written, Amazing Facts, Faith of Jesus. And we've introduced the quarterly now, starting this year. So the idea is also teach them about our faith, teach them about Bible, biblical truths, but as well also make them some sort of train them in leadership in church and leadership in as much as they can. We have certain people that go and share. We promote them because we can't go to the dorms, so we ask them to go and share what they've learned with others. And that's the reason why we've been able to be successful, because they've understood the message also that we believe in, to go and share what they know with others.
You're developing leaders among them.
That's the goal. That's the goal. You know, unfortunately, at times they leave a little bit sooner than we like, but, you know, we pray that when they go back home, they continue to share this with their family.
So what would you say to a church that said, we want to start a prison ministry? Any tips on what to do, what not to do?
I would say do it. I would say go ahead. It's fun. It sounds scary, but once you understand it, it's very rewarding. It's very rewarding to see people completely turn their lives around if you've never tried it. But there's a process to go to. You would want to go to your local, not your local, but the nearest prison that you have if you want to do this particular ministry. Depending on state, county, different levels, they'll ask for a training. You'll look for a chaplain or the person in charge with the volunteer department, and they'll explain to you if there's a process, you have to go some sort of training, how long the training will be, what it'll be about, and how often you have to renew that. Like, for example, for us, it's every 2 years. You have to go in person and renew the training.
That, how long was the training for that unit?
It's about an hour.
Okay.
They'll go over procedures. They'll go over do's and don'ts. They'll go over a dress code. They'll go over, you know, in case of emergencies, you know, things like that.
So you really got to know a lot of these people there behind bars, and they become friends and fellow brothers in the Lord.
They do. Actually, I don't know where this is going to be shared, but several of them have asked us for addresses, and we believe that that's where they're going. We have people going to Houston, people going to Lubbock, Amarillo. A good friend of mine is about to release this month to go to Amarillo. And he asked me, I thought it was very interesting. He asked me to write a letter, and I immediately thought about Paul. Because he asked me to write a letter on his behalf to the brothers and the different churches, because he's willing to go out and serve and help, and he wants to be part of a church, and he wants to, as soon as he gets there, you know, be fellowship with them. So I'm working on contacting the members and the pastors there, kind of like Paul, tell him, hey, I'm sending you my brother, that, you know, I hope that you guys embrace him, and that he can continue learning about Christ with you guys. So,
amen.
We're also able to do, if you become a volunteer, you're able to do a mentoring program, which is a little extra training online. It's also about another hour or so. But you're able to have contact with their families if they let you. You're able to help them also and have contact with the prisoner also through mail, or also talk on their behalf on different agencies and the community resources, things like that. So I've also mentoring four different inmates as of now, and we're trying also with our volunteers to get more people started, because a lot of people want to learn more about this lifestyle of following Jesus not just what the Bible says, but also how to put it to practice, how to live it, you know, within families, within jobs, within different areas. So it's very rewarding. It's very fun. It does sound kind of weird that it's fun, but it's fun when you put to practice, you know, the Bible.
Amen. Thanks so much for sharing. This is wonderful.
No problem.